Let me mention a few typical mistakes that you should avoid when you implement your experiment. There won't be anything new here, everything here has been already covered in the course, but because I see these mistakes made by online businesses from time to time, I figured it's better to highlight them one more time. Number one, you should assign your A and B versions randomly. When you use a service like Optimizely or Google Optimize, this won't be an issue. These tools do the randomization for you. But when you want to run an experiment where you have to assign your audience to your A and B versions by yourself, you should make sure that you use a random generator that will do the job for you. I see people making silly randomization mistakes, like the first half of their registered users sees version A, the second half sees version B. See, that's a problem, because those users who registered earlier might act very differently than those users who registered later. So you should assign your A and B versions randomly. Number two, A and B versions should run parallel. I mean, I guess at this point, I don't have to tell you that if you run your version A in September for your whole audience, then your version B in October, well, that's not an A-B test. Again, if you do this, the seasonality effect can mess up your results, so make sure that you run your experiments properly and your variations run parallel with each other. Number three, your users should not know that they are a part of an experiment. So don't tell them in an email or in a pop-up. Also, don't tell them that they can opt out of version B to go back to version A. These things could bias their behavior. Again, this should be obvious, but I've seen this mistake made too many times. Number four, responsivity. Before you start your experiments, you have to make sure that your new versions are working properly on all devices. For instance, if your version B is broken on mobile phones, well, that's not good for your brand, but also it will skew your A-B test results because a broken new design will always convert worse than the original one, however good your A-B testing idea was. Number five, avoid flickering. We have talked about this in detail. When a user sees a flickering website, she will know that she's a part of an experiment, and even if she doesn't, seeing this flickering on a website is never a good user experience, and for that, this might also skew your test results. So watch out for these five things. They are obvious mistakes, but I see them happening from time to time. Okay, this is it. We are done with the second step of executing a great A-B test. If you have done everything right so far at the preparation and implementation steps, then you came up with a promising, well-funded A-B test idea, and now you have set it up properly. There are only two steps left: running the A-B test and then evaluating it.